It's been a rough week for Oklahoma State, hasn't it? It's been actually a rough year for them, too. I know what you're saying. Like, you're an Oklahoma fan. You've ever had a rough year, too. Believe me, I know. I've watched. But there are subtle differences here than a little thing called momentum and going into next year and who hasn't, who doesn't. And right now, it's not Oklahoma State. I don't care what the final records are because I'll be straight up. I don't expect OU to win their bowl game today as I'm recording this. If they win, great. I'll eat crow on that. Hooray, we won. But I don't care if OSU, if they finish 7-6 and we're 6-7. We still had a better year. One, we beat y'all because you couldn't beat the worst OU team since 1999. And add to the fact that you started off like, what, 6-1, 7-1, and proceeded to lose 4 out of your last 5. You had control of potentially playing for a Big 12 championship, squandered that. And then you go into your bowl game. And listen, I don't care if you win or lose your bowl game. I'm going to be consistent on this across the board. I think bowl games are dead anyway. So whether you win or lose is inconsequential to me. It's just funny for some people that you lost to a program who fired their coach in the middle of the year and had Luke Fickell come in and just coach whatever was left there. And they were able to hold on and win. So take that for what it's worth right there. But then we get to this juicy part right after the game, because the post-game press conference, the last question, watch this bit right here.
So staff changes are starting to happen earlier and earlier now with the portal being a thing. Do you anticipate making any changes to your staff between now and next season?
Do you think I would tell you if I was making staff changes?
No, but I have
to. Then why would you ask?
Because I have to. It's my job.
Okay, well, I might have to cut you out. I mean, don't be an ass. Really? I mean, those people's lives, man. It's people's families, right? Okay, don't mess with people's families. Let's do this the right way. You with me on this? I mean, it's not fair to people's families, man.
Right, that will conclude our press conference.
I'm not mad about the game. I just don't like ignorance.
This is Mike Gundy. People get mad, oh, it's not the right time or the right place. When are they supposed to ask this question about, you know, replacing members of the staff? They ain't going to be talking to Mike for a while. This is the last time you're going to speak to Mike Gundy. It's not like there's a signing day coming up because we already went past that. You know, it's going to be about a month or so before you talk to him. So, hey, Mike, are you going to make any staff changes or blah, blah, blah? Oh, you can't ask him right if they lost the game. Bull. It's like, and he gets on, is like, oh, you know I'm not going to answer that. Well, guess what? He asked the question. And the reason why you ask questions like that is because you never know when something like that will happen. He had a little bit of a mini meltdown. And then he threatens to pull credentials to one of his Homer beat reporters. He basically threatens, like, oh, you're not being Homer. He basically wasn't being Homer enough. And threatens publicly to take his credentials. To then you see this, where the reporter gets on his hands and knees, begs for forgiveness on Twitter. Please, Mike, don't take my credentials. I know every local media for college football teams, especially for big ones and Power Five, are all considered listed homers. But man, this doesn't help the cause if you're trying to say, oh no, there's impartial people around. But man, it's just, that sounds like a guy who feels like he has job security. Because this is Oklahoma State right now. Mike Gundy has a job forever, it seems, because there's nothing he can do to lose his gig. And as an OU fan, I'm like, fine. I hope Mike Gundy stays there forever. Because it just proves my point that he's gone stale. He's starting to go senile. He's losing his mind. And but the Titanic is about to sink. It's already hit the iceberg. It's going to be too late. Because your recruiting class ranking is 63rd, as opposed to 29th from last year. 0 4-star composite recruits for this upcoming recruiting class y'all brought in. Oh, it's a smaller class. I don't care. Could you get at least a handful of 4-stars to make it look less pathetic? See, people danced in our grave last year, especially Polk fans. Oh, we beat Oklahoma. We killed Lincoln Riley. I saw all y'all. I saw all in the comments, saw you on Twitter, saw you on message boards. I saw you everywhere. Dancing on our grave. And granted, Oklahoma had a crappy season this year, 6-6. But guess what we got going on? Top 5 recruiting class. We got momentum going into next year. So, you know, we flush out the negative, insert the positive, and guess what? We'll be back. next year, we'll be fine. I don't expect to necessarily go to the playoff or maybe not even win the Big 12. I think we can make it to Arlington if we, you know, play well and we have certain guys that are freshmen step up. But those are a lot of ifs. Your program, by the way, you need to take a look in the mirror because Spencer Sanders is leaving. Just leaving, and you seem to be okay with that or upset about that. A bunch of guys are jumping ship. But then we get to my favorite part, because rumors of Trace Ford transferring to Oklahoma. Now, he was, like, picking between OU and USC or whatever, but Edmund kid, dude wanted to stay close to home, and, well, he'll never transfer to his rival now, will he? Well, guess what he did? Trace Ford transferred to Oklahoma. But, man, and the Pokes came out, and I normally don't talk about random fan stuff on here because it's just a waste of time. But, you know, the typical toxic message board, I hope he gets AIDS and die, he's not welcome here, blah, blah, blah. I expect that from Twitter guy, message board guy, Facebook guy. I expect that garbage from all of them. But, boy, the leader of the pack had to get his 2 cents in. Doug freaking Gottlieb, of all people, who's known for, you know, lack of credit, because if he doesn't have any, he'll just steal yours. Quote tweets. He quote tweeted Trace Ford and said, "This is the essence of a bullshit move. I don't care about circumstances. Don't care about NIL. You don't ever transfer to your arch rival. Of course, Twitter will say it is great. This is a grown-up decision, and his is bullshit. Feel free to hand in your O jacket on your way out." I expect that from, like, Orange Power. I expect that from Robert Allen. Doug Gottlieb. Actually, I'm not really shocked it came from Doug Gottlieb, because Doug Gottlieb is just an asshole. He is one of the most pathetic media members that has a microphone on a national level. Doug Gottlieb is a giant piece of shit. He steals, back in the day, he would steal old school Bleacher Report articles from people and claim it as his own idea. You know, he'll make false claims about Major League Baseball contracts and just on and on and on. There's so many piss poor takes that Doug Gottlieb has. He's just an absolute little worm, and I wish he would go away. But again, it just adds to the embarrassment for OSU right now, because, you know, love him or hate him, you know, they're staying in the new Big 12 or whatever it's going to be, and the day Mike Gundy leaves, because it's going to happen, that's going to come a lot sooner than later, but I want Pokes out there, y'all need to ask yourself a question right now. When are some of you going to take a step back and stop being mad at players leaving or mad that the program's not going well right now? Take a look in the mirror and ask yourselves, who's responsible for this right now? Because to steal a quote from Red Dirt Sport, it might be the guy sitting at home watching OAN on his television and not recruiting, not getting into NIL, not getting into the transfer portal, not taking the extra step to make Oklahoma State a more consistent power program that, frankly, it could be. But he doesn't want to do the things that it takes. So Bob Stoops was like that at times. He didn't want to take the extra step with social media and everything. So at some point, he decided enough was enough, and he did the right thing and gave the program to what we thought at the time was a good choice. And for a few years, it was. But Mike Gundy's not going to do that, is he? He's got a job for life. He knows it. That's why he can get away with little circus acts like at that media press conference, where he can just, like, pick and choose who he wants to be there to, like, you know, kiss his feet and suck up to him. That's Mike Gundy, ladies and gentlemen. He does not give a F about what's going on right now, because he knows he can stay there forever. He's won you a couple of major bowl games. He beats Oklahoma once every 10 years, something like that. And, yeah. You're happy with that. That will sustain you for a decade until you beat us the next time. But we're leaving to go to the SEC, so next year might be your last chance. So good luck with that. We'll see what happens next year, because I don't think you're going to be very good. And we're going to go out the door, possibly Big 12 champions. We shall see. But again, Oklahoma State, this is why you are what you are. You're basically great value Auburn. And you always will be, as long as Mike Gundy is your head coach.